Hi, hello everyone from Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. Today we are going to discuss about graph coloring using backtracking. Myself, Dr. M. Purushottam Reddy, Associate Professor and Head of the Department of Information Technology. These are the course objectives of this subject, Design and Analysis of Algorithms. This is the course outcome with respect to this this chapter, backtracking. After successful completion of this course, students will be able to utilize backtracking and branch and bound techniques to deal with traceable and intraceable problems. Graph coloring. First, here in this slide, first we discuss about what is meant by graph coloring problem. Graph coloring problem is, let G be a graph and M be any given positive integer. We want to discover if the nodes of G can be colored in such a way that no two adjacent nodes have the same color, yet only M colors are used. The M colorability optimization problem asks for the smallest integer n. That smallest integer n is called as chromatic number for which graph can be colored. For example, here we see that we take some graph. Now here we see that this graph contains four nodes. We color each and every node with some color. But here in this graph coloring problem, the condition is the any two adjacent nodes, they don't have same color. Suppose here this one filled with red. Now this one here, we see that here this graph consists of four nodes. In these four nodes, we fill this graph with colors. Any two adjacent nodes, they don't have the same color. Suppose here we choose the node for this node, we choose red color. We don't choose red color for this adjacent node and this adjacent node. We choose different colors. We choose blue color here. Here also we choose blue color. Here this one is not adjacent to this node, so here we choose red color. Here four nodes are there. We choose two different colors, red and blue. Minimum two different colors we choose and we fill these nodes. This problem is called graph coloring problem. Here minimum how many colors you need? Two colors. That two is called as chromatic number. Once again, I'm repeating this one. Let G be a graph. It has some nodes. Suppose here this graph has four nodes. We fill these nodes with the different colors. Here the condition is any two adjacent nodes, they don't have the same color. And as here we fill this graph with minimum number of colors, that minimum number is called as chromatic number. Here this graph, it consists of four different nodes. Here suppose we fill this first node with red color, we won't choose that same red color for the adjacent node, this and this nodes. So we choose another different color, blue. And also here we use the same red color here. This node is not adjacent to this node. So here we use two minimum colors to fill this graph. So this two is called as chromatic number. This graph is called as graph coloring problem. So a graph is planar if it can drawn in a plane such a way that no two edges crosses each other. Four color problem asks if a map can be colored in such a way that no two regions have the same color, yet only four colors are needed. Now here we see that planar graph means here. Suppose we'll take this. This is a graph. Here in this graph we observe that no two edges are not crosses each other. So this is a planar graph. Suppose we draw like this. This is not a planar graph. Here this edge and this edge, both edges, they cross each other. So this is not a planar graph. Suppose you want to draw this planar, non-planar graph into planar graph. So like this, we draw this one. So we draw this edge like HDS. We draw this edge like this. So now edge between these two nodes also there, but we redraw that one. Now this non-planar graph converted into planar graph. And also here, that four color problem asks if a map can be colored in such a way that no two regions have the same color, yet only four colors are needed. Here maximum four colors we needed. Minimum, we decrease that number of colors. That minimum number is called as chromatic number. Suppose we see this graph. In this graph, suppose here we fill with red color. This vertex, all these three vertices are adjacent to this one now. So now we use here different colors. Here blue color. Here green color. This one is also adjacent to this node. So all the remaining three nodes are adjacent to this node. Remaining three nodes are adjacent to this node. Remaining three edges are the nodes are adjacent to this one. Remaining three nodes are adjacent to this one. So here we have edges between them. Whenever we have edges between them, automatically they are adjacent to each other. So here we use some yellow color. So here for this graph, we need how many colors minimum? Four colors. So this four here is called as chromatic number. Suppose the graph like this is there. Now here we see that this is A edge, this is B, this is C, D. A is not adjacent to C. Similarly, B is not adjacent to D. Now here we use red. We don't use red here and here in B and D, but we use red here because A and C are not adjacent nodes. Similarly, here we use blue. Here also we use blue. So with minimum two colors, we fill this one. So this two is called as chromatic number of this graph. Next, we come to this graph. A map and corresponding graph is given. So this is the given graph. So here we see that 1 2 2 1 2 3 2 2 4 2 2 5 4 2 5 1 2 5 these edges are there. Now here one is filled with white color. One is adjacent to 3 5 2 2 3 5. So in 2 3 5 we won't use this white color. Next, here in 2 we use blue color. So in 2, in here in region 2 we use blue color. 2 is adjacent to 3 1 4 5. So all remaining four nodes are adjacent. So this blue color we won't use in any way, in any regions. So in 2 we want to use this one, in 3 we want to use this one, in 4 we want to use this one, in 5 also we want to use this one. Next, 3. In 3 we use this color. So this 3 is adjacent to 5, is 3 adjacent to 4, 3 is adjacent, 3 adjacent to 2, 5, 1. So in that one we want to use these colors. So use some other colors. 4 use red color. In 5 use this is adjacent to 3, so use another different color. Here some yellow color use. So in this way we are representing graph coloring. So you are representing the graph coloring with the different colors. Now this is the algorithm. This is the M coloring of K. So here K means a number of colors or number of nodes which in that graph. So here repeat. Here next value of k algorithm we recall here. If x of k equal to 0, then return no color is possible. K is number of colors. If x of k equal to 0, no color is possible. If x of k equal to n means at most m colors been, we choose from that for that n vertices. So write x of 1 to n. We write all the vertices, vertices with colors. So here else m coloring of k plus 1. Again we're repeating this process. So until false. That means until you find the number of colors for the given graph. So here first m color of k means k colors we choose to color the given nodes in the graph. First repeat next value of k, which we call next value algorithm. If x of k equal to 0 means no color is there to color that graph. If k equal to n means at most m colors are there to color that n vertices of the graph. Write all that colors x of 1 to n. Else m coloring of k plus 1, again we call that m coloring coloring algorithm, and we're repeating this process until false means until you fill these colors with that graph. This is next value of k algorithm. In this next value of k algorithm, mainly which color we choose for the next node, like that we are choosing the next color for all that nodes. Repeat x of k equal to x of k plus 1 mod m plus 1. So here we choose next higher color using this one. If x of k equal to 0, then return. If x of k equal to 0 means all colors are already used. So if j equal to 1 to n, do repeating for all the n vertices. If g of k comma j, g of k comma j not equal to 0, and x of k equal to x of j. Here kij is an edge between two vertices, then we say that the two vertices are adjacent. That means we are not using the same color. So then break. So we're repeating for the remaining vertices. If j equal to n plus 1, then return. So new color we choose and repeating for the remaining vertices. So until we fill all the colors, until all colors to nodes, we're repeating this one. This is the next value. That means next color we choose for the next node in the given graph. For that one, use this next value of k algorithm. So this is the given graph 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, this is the state space tree for this graph. Here we see that here first node x equal to 1 means for first node we choose one color. Suppose first node we choose red color. We choose x2 equal to 2. X2 equal to 2 means we choose another color for this one, some blue. X3 equal to 1 means we choose for third node some another color, some green. X4 equal to 2 means again we choose the same color, blue. This one is red color. X2 equal to 1 means first color. Next year, x2 equal to 3. X2 equal to 3 means we choose other than this. This is one first color, this is second color. Other than these two, we choose another color, yellow. Yellow means here, now 3. X2 equal to 3 means here, yellow. Here, yellow color. Now, x2 equal to 3 means yellow color. Here, this is third color. Blue is second color. Next we choose. So like that we choose different colors. Here x3 equal to 1 means again we choose same red color for x3 here. Here x4 equal to 2 means we chose for this one for blue color. So suppose this condition is not satisfied, again come back and we choose x3 equal to 2. X3 equal to 2 means here blue color we choose. So here we choose different alternatives. So this state space tree, it represents different alternatives. So choosing this graph coloring of this one. But here how many minimum colors we need means for this for coloring this graph means here we need only two colors, red, blue, red. Only two colors we need. That means x here one, this is 2, this is 1. So x1 equal to 1, x2 equal to 2, x3 equal to 1, x4 equal to 2. So x1 equal to 1, x2 equal to 2, x3 equal to 1, x4 equal to 1. So this is one solution. Now similarly, x2 equal to 2, 2, 1, 2, 1. This is also another solution. So these are the solutions with minimum number of colors of field. So in these two cases, this is the optimized solutions for this given graph coloring. So, and also here we observe that here the minimum number of colors is only 2. So in this case only 2, and also here 3, 1, 2, 1. So here we take more colors, 3, 1, 3, 1. This is also another optimized solutions. So like this, we get optimized solutions, more than one optimized solutions for the given graph. But here the minimum number of colors, choosing that one is called as chromatic number. Maximum how many number of colors we choose means, suppose we have four nodes are there in the graph, we choose four colors. Suppose in that graph we have five colors means maximum we choose five colors. Less than five colors we choose five or equal to five or less than five colors we choose to color the graph. So here the minimum number of colors to color the graph, that one is called as chromatic number. So next we come to time complexity. Number of internal nodes in the state space tree are summation over I equal to 1 to n minus 1 m, where n is the number of nodes and m is the colors. At each internal node, big O of m n time is needed by next value to determine the children corresponding to legal colorings. Hence, the total time or the time complexity of this graph coloring is big O of n into m power n. So this is the time complexity of this graph coloring algorithm. So thanks to everyone.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.